ஜாலி ஹாலிடே. இப்போ வந்து பார்த்தீங்கன்னா இவங்க மலேசியா மட்டும் தாய்லாண்டுக்கு பெஸ்ட்டான ஆஃபர் கொடுத்துட்ருக்காங்க. ஆமாங்க, மலேசியாக்கோ இல்லை தாய்லாண்ட் போகிறதுக்கோ வெறும் 20,000 ரூபாயில் டூர் பேக்கேஜ் பண்ணி கொடுக்குறாங்க. இந்த 20,000 தங்கிறதுக்கான 3-star ஹோட்டல், விசா, சுற்றி பார்க்குற சைட் சீயிங்கு, அது இல்லாமல் ஏர்போர்ட் பிக்கப் பண்ணுறாப்பும் பண்ணி கொடுக்குறாங்க. ஆமாங்க, நீங்கள் வந்து மலேசியாவோ இல்லை தாய்லாண்டோ இல்லை வேறு எந்த நாட்டுக்கோ அப்படி இல்லை இந்தியாவுக்குள்ளே பல இடங்களுக்கு சுற்றி பார்க்கணும் அப்படின்னு நினச்சிங்கன்னா ஜாலி ஹாலிடேஸ் உங்களுக்கு பெஸ்ட்டான ஆப்ஷனாக இருக்கும். ஏன்னா கம்மியான பட்ஜெட்டில் அற்புதமாக பண்ணி கொடுக்குறாங்க. ஸோ கீழே டிஸ்கிரிப்ஷன்லையும் கமெண்ட்லேயும் அவங்களோட லிங்க் இருக்கு, அவங்களை காண்டாக்ட் பண்ணி டூருக்கு போய் என்ஜாய் பண்ணுங்க.
ஹலோ கைஸ், வெல்கம் வெல்கம் பேக் டு அவர் சேனல் தமிழ் ட்ரெக்கர். டுடே வி ஆர் இன் அ வில்லேஜ் 70 kilometers அவே ஃப்ரம் இலக்கக்கா கால்ட் கரி ராபே. த நேம் ஆஃப் த பிளேஸ் இஸ் கரி ராபே. த நேம் ஸ்டாண்ட்ஸ் ஃபார் த லாஸ்ட் பிளேஸ் ஆஃப் மைனிங். தட்ஸ் த நேம் ஆஃப் த பிளேஸ் பை நவ் யூ வுட் ஹவ் நோன் தட். அன்லைக் ஆன் வீக் டேஸ் வென் தௌசண்ட்ஸ் ஆஃப் பீப்புள் இன் த ஃபாரஸ்ட் ஆர் இன்வால்வ் இன் மைனிங், ஆன் சண்டேஸ் தேர் உட் பி லெஸ் பீப்புள். ஸோ தட்ஸ் வேர் வி ஆர் ஹெட்டட் டு. வி கோட் தட் இன்ஃபர்மேஷன் ஃப்ரம் த லோக்கல் பீப்புள். ஸோ ரைட் நவ் வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு த பிளேஸ். அஸ் யூ கேன் சி, வி ஆர் வாக்கிங் இன் த ஃபாரஸ்ட் ஏரியா. த வில்லேஜ் இஸ் 5 kilometers அவே ஃப்ரம் ஹியர். வி ஹவ் ஸ்டாப்ட் அவர் கார் நியர் பை அண்ட் வாக்கிங் டுவர்ட்ஸ் த மைண்ட். ஹியர் பீப்புள் டு வாக் டு த மைண்ட்ஸ், ஒர்க் ஆல் டே அண்ட் கம் பேக் ஹோம் இன் த ஈவினிங். தட்ஸ் ஹவ் தே சர்வைவ். Madagascar is well known for gold, sapphire and ruby mining. It's what people do here. So how can we miss seeing the gold mining? So let's see how they mine gold and how is it being sold here. We'll see in detail. Guess it will take 30 minutes to reach there. Yesterday we learned about sapphire trade in Hilakaka. And by 1:30 p.m. today we have to board the bus to Tana. We came here yesterday and we'll start for Tana today, tolling to a 24 hours journey. We'll be subjugated to long journeys and locations. Here are far flung. It'll take hours. To shoot one video, we need to travel a long distance. We have journeyed for 3 hours. It will take another 3 hours in our way back. And from there, a 24 hours journey. Don't know how I will handle it. Can you see a lake there? That's where we are headed to. That is where sand is rinsed to find gold. Such a grueling work is required to find the gold. See, the people are walking over the lake. So this is how we need to go. There are 1,000 sites to mine gold in Madagascar. In fact, over 1,000. But I could have shown you something on the main road. But to give a different experience, I'm going to the interior site. That's why we are traveling this far. Just for our subscribers, for the first time, please like my video. Madagascar series numbers aren't too great, but in order to keep up with our USP, I'm making different videos. See how they are going. Welcome to Madagascar, people. In Madagascar, we need to do all this stuff. No other go. Oh, the lake is getting deeper. The adventure begins. The water's coming inward. Now the water is knee-deep. Oh God. Oh gosh, we have reached at last. They are digging something. See, the gold mine. I'm witnessing this for the first time like you. Guys, see here. The whole area is for mining. People stay here in huts and mine gold. People rinse the sand here, it seems. See? Oh my God. They digged everywhere. This is the lake. Since people's livelihood depends on it, we aren't supposed to wear footwear here. Wearing a footwear here is blasphemous, and we are supposed to buy goat, cow and chicken as an atonement. So let's remove the footwear. Let's see. People take away water and dig the sand and deposit it separately. From this, gold will be mined. We are yet to know where we get gold here and whether it's get washed here after rains. We don't know about the source of the water. They are digging here and they are digging in that place nearby. From there they are collecting gold. Actually, the people were scared to see us with cameras. I guess they are mining illegally. So we are next going to Madagascar from here. Okay. See, we have started our journey right now. And you can see some people are sitting at the back of our car. Since they are from the hilly region, they can get to the place only on foot. There is no access to bus or any vehicle. When they see people in cars, they ask for lift. We hitch them for a ride. Even when we came here in the morning, a family traveled along with us. So that's how people live here. If they want to purchase something or go to nearby places, they ask for lift and travel. They asked us for help for traveling. As a fellow human being, we are doing that. Even by the morning, we were accompanied by the local people who live here. That's how everyone help each other here. Hi guys, right now we are in a village 50 kilometers away from Madagascar. The purpose of visit is to see the mining of gold. Yes, the piles of sand you see here as gold hidden in it. The sand is getting shoveled and getting rinsed to find gold. See, they are shoveling. See, they are shoveling now. At one point, they pour water in it and start rinsing it to find gold. The gold collected here was just sold yesterday. The sand is being rinsed elsewhere. Let me show you. You can see all the people work here or doing a hard work to collect some gold from the sand. Let me show you. See, people are uprooting trees and bushes and then shoveling sand looking for gold. See, this woman is shoveling. Ah. Yeah. See, everyone is shoveling. See, the sand is collected in a sack and is taken over there to get it rinsed. That's how they collect the gold. Okay. See here. This is how they are collecting gold. Not even an inch long, but just tiny speck. Such gold specks are collected and it is separated from soil and other element by mixing a chemical to it. They do all the separation here. As you can see, even a small kid is working here. In Madagascar, if there is a gold mine in any area, only the local people belonging to that area can collect the gold that doesn't belong to the government. The people who live in that locality can dig gold and sell it. No other people can do it. Whereas in our country, we can dig only to a particular extent, after which the rights belong to the government. We don't have the permission to dig further or else we'll be in jail. Apart from gold mining, they also harvest grains for their food needs. That's how they meet their daily needs. These are their homes. Salama. See, the women is rinsing. This is how they do it. They are doing a teamwork. See, this is how they do it. See, even that woman has a golden teeth. Can you see? She's smiling. this is how they rinse. After rinsing, just a speck of gold remains in the filter. Wonder how much they sell this for, whether on a gram basis like in India or otherwise. So for a week, over 60 people have worked and were able to collect just 200 grams. Not just 200 grams, it's sizable. They have sold it in the market yesterday. When asked, they said they sold it for rupees 4000 per gram, but local says a gram is 2000, beyond 2000 rupees only. This is how they live here. They have less expenditure as they grow their own food. Selling gold hasn't made them affluent, they are still poor. See, they don't look rich actually. They are still living a very poor life. See, there are stones here. We get stones and gold too. Actually, Madagascar is known as the golden paradise because you could find gold anywhere you dig. There are over 5,000 sites in Madagascar where you can find gold. And both the government buys the gold from here and also it leaves the country illegally without any hassle. But there are no legal means of exporting from here yet. But still the mining goes on because life has to go on. This is how they live here. See how she is rinsing? After rinsing, just a speck of gold remains in that filter. She don't give up easily, it seems. This waterway is completely used for this purpose. The collected sand is deposited here, from here. Then it gets rinsed because there is a catchment area here. I want to know the next step, but she's taking too long to rinse. Maybe she won't show the next step. With this technique, they bring the gold particles to the center. It's amazing. I don't know exactly how they do it, but they know that gold settled in the center. If in case we do it, we'd be confused as the water and gold will be in the same color. It needs a lot of experience and handwork. Since they are experienced, they are able to differentiate between the two. See how they are moving it? Very casually. It takes a lot of effort to learn this process. That's it. Can you see gold here? Yes, here. So much hard work goes into finding this gold. Wow, it's amazing. Guys, there is a snake. That is not venomous, right?
It's not venomous.
Whoa.
Is it gone?
Escape. Guys, look how they are filtering out the soil. Looks like he is an expert. Whoa.
This is a form of the gold.
Look how it is. Is this edible? Eating this will only bring diseases. Mm. This is how much she earned today after so much of hard work.
Take it for you.
Like I said before, Madagascar has several gold mines from which 100 kilograms of gold are being collected on a daily basis. Actually, it is more than 100 kilos. This is only the legally accounted number. Sky is the limit for legal mining. And see here two people are rinsing. They go down only for water. Then the sand is collected in a sack and is taken over there to get rinsed. Can you see a pot over there? It's gold in there. No matter how much gold they collect, the life of the people is not that much good and people live in a very poor conditions. To get into interior regions of Madagascar, we need to travel for a very long time. I got here after 2.5 days of travel to just find the gold mines. This is what is causing delays in uploading Madagascar's video. Really sorry for the delay, guys. Or else we'll be uploading videos as quick as possible. Sometimes we need to sit in bus for 1 or 2 days. Travel is not easy. With all that, we'll be wrapping up Madagascar series successfully. After visiting some places, I'll be going to France, the France Reunion Islands. That is island in France that is called Reunion, where there are many Tamils. I'll be exploring that. There is even a volcano there. I'll be sending 100 postcards to subscribers. Last time from Mauritius, I sent 50 postcards. There is a question given in link below. I have planned to send 100 postcards from here. Let's see how many of you give out the right answers. In Madagascar, I'm going to send for 100 people. Let's see how many of you give right answers and win the postcards. After our successful completion of the gold mines, now we are at the vanilla farms. Yes, guys, vanilla farm. You remember our favorite ice cream flavor? Yes. In the whole world, 70% of vanilla is sourced from Madagascar. You'll be from any part of the world, but you'll be tasting vanilla from Madagascar, for sure. Right now, we are in a small garden where vanilla is grown. The vanilla flavor and vanilla essence we eat is actually looks green in color. This is actually how it looks. The longer the leaf is, the more price it would fetch. This is called vanilla beans. It is first in green color. Upon processing, it turns yellow, then orange, and only then black, which yes. gives a flavor of vanilla. Actually, this is the last process of vanilla. The one I hold is the final product of vanilla that gives the flavor to the ice cream we eat. This is the last process of vanilla. This is not the first quality, it's the second quality. When we smell it, the aroma is really amazing, guys. Wow, awesome, guys. I'm smelling vanilla in its original form. Wow. This is not edible. It's only to add flavor. Superb, guys. Actually, they pluck the green vanilla beans first. Then they will put it in a warm water. They have the measurements too, particular temperature. Then they will check the temperature. Then they will leave it in a bag. Then they will soak the green vanilla in the water. Then they will let it dry. Not in a scorching heat, but in a medium heat. Then take into shadow. To get black vanilla from green vanilla, it will take up to 3 weeks of process for the final output. That is first green, then yellow, and then orange, then only black color. If the black one blasts in the heat, then it will go waste. The quality is lost. It should not be damaged and unbroken. It will be the first quality. It's a huge process. That is the main reason why vanilla is very, very costly. The one we use in our ice creams are just synthetic flavors. That's what we get in our country. But the actual original ones are very, very costly.
These See, are
they
the
have
qualities.
Separated according to the quality. The first two one are unbroken beans and are the first quality. The other two are broken. It is used
it's
in chocolate,
used in
ice
medicines.
Cream and medicine. See, these, since they are broken, they are pushed to second quality. And the last one is being smaller in size, is of a third quality. So this is how the qualities are determined and sold accordingly. So guys, vanilla is being called the world's second popular spice. Actually, here not many people know how to process it well. On sending into Europe and US for processing the vanilla, the price of vanilla hits the roof just like that. Which is why vanilla is called the second most costliest spice in the world. Can you see the drawing of a man taking the aroma of vanilla? Exactly like how I felt on smelling it. I really felt very awesome. If you get a chance to smell vanilla, you have to smell and try it. I'll try to bring some to India if I can. When I arrange meetup, I'll surely show the vanilla. I don't know how much they will charge for vanilla here. Madagascar can aptly be called a paradise. You can get everything here, right from stones to gold to vanilla. All pricey stuffs are available here. The region's names Manakara seems to have been derived from the Tamils Manal and Karai, which means sand and shore, according to the researchers. And some people say Madagascar was connected to Tamil Nadu before. It's very amazing to know such information that South India in general to Kerala and Karnataka too. The soil we see here is very much similar to our land completely. Is this first quality? I guess the first quality will be very much longer and lengthier than this.